I'm back with another new video on computer tips and tricks. In today's video, I'll discuss about computer disk partition management. If you're new to the channel, please stay tuned by subscribing to the channel and turning on notifications. And if you have already subscribed, the new video with new information for you. Let's start the video. We usually create, delete, format partitions when we install the operating system. In case we don't create partitions while installing the operating system, we'll just install the operating system on our storage drive. After that, when the operating system installation is complete, we enter our computer and we can create, format, delete or extend this partition as we need or we can assign later to partition drive. So let's see how to do that. On my computer, I can see four drives now. But here I had one more drive which is now unallocated. That's why I'm not visible here. If there is a problem that my computer's drive is supposed to be here, but why is it not visible here? Let's see how we can see exactly how many partitions we have or whether any partitions are hidden. And how to make it visible. That's why we can access the locations in two ways. One way is that our computer has this PC or my computer. After right-clicking the dialog box that opens, there is an option called Manage. I'm going to the video from Windows 11, which is why we have to go to the next dialog box. That's why I will click on Show More option. After clicking here, we get the Manage option. In Windows 10 or lower versions, the Manage option is open directly in the first dialog box. Now, if we click on Manage option, then a new window will open. In that window, in the storage block, there is an option called Disk Management. Click on it. So we can see four drives in disk 0, but one drive is 101 GB, which is unallocated. So it is not visible on our computer due to being is this unallocated state. We can make it visible from here very easily. In another way, we can come to this window. In that case, we'll go to the search option and search for create and format hard disk partition. Then this option is coming as a search result. If we click on this option, then we can directly access that window. If you click on New Simple with right click on Unallocated Drive, then click Next. Here the simple volume is being created. I leave the volume default. Then go to the next button and assign the drive later of the drive. Here we can assign letters as we wish. After clicking on the next button, a volume called new volume has been created after formatting. Now if I access my computer, then I can see the new drive. Next, we'll see how to split the drive into two more partitions. In that case, after we come to this dialog window, we can divide it into multiple partitions by right-clicking on the new volume drive and clicking on the shrink volume option. If we want to make two partitions from 100 GB to 50 GB, then we will input the MB size that will be for my 50 GB here. If we set this value, then a drive like 50 GB will be created. Then click on shrink button, then unallocated drive is created. If we want to make it visible on the display, we can make it visible in the previous process by right click. We have seen how to create multiple drives by partitioning on drive. Now by going to this spreadsheet, we will see the new partitions. Now if I can change the later path and maintain the sequence and category of the drives, I can take this middle drive to this end with my later path change. In that case, we can go to this window and change the later path in the same process. Here it shows the SSD index 0 and the SSD index on. The next drive is compact disk drive, which has age later. If we move the age later path after I, then we can change the later path. Here I changed age to J by clicking on change option. Now to make this drive for J, the drive later sequence is showing later. Now change the I later path to H. I will see how I can convert these two drives into on drive. Another thing, if you were to partition this drive, then we could easily partition the free space that is here. It would not erase any data on the drive. Let's extend this drive. Right click on it. In the dialog box that opens, the extend volume menu appears disabled because it requires an allocated drive to extend, which is not available here. So delete this drive. Now this drive has become an allocated drive. Now if we right click on this drive and click on extend volume, then click on next button. An allocated drive is shown here. It is selected by default. If it is not selected, select it and click on the next button. Then click on the next button.